Up to now, we've only showed you half of what you can do with the module database in that you can use aliases in your calculations. But what about properties? Well, to get a property, you have to know, again, what the current path of the variable is. And we've given you a function called a getPyModuleFromPath, and that will return the module for a specific context. And if you want the current context, it is stored at runtime in a variable. In VB6, it's stored as master ace context, or in the VB.NET development environment, just context. And you can use those functions, those calls, to get the current, not only the current path to your module, but also to get the proper property as well. And here's an example where we will set a variable that we've dimensioned as a PI module. We've set that variable equal to get PI module from path using the master ace context. We then define a variable and set it to the following values: the coefficient value times the area value, and then we do some other functions to it here. But this is a perfect example of how you might get properties. In this case, we've got area and coefficient as two properties of this heat exchanger. And we're getting those through the code, and we're not only getting the properties, we're using them in a calculation. And so let's take a few moments and turn to look at how we might do this with our units and our flow that we talked about a few moments ago. If we go back to our code, remember after we have turned the executable off, or we don't want that permission denied message, we need to first dimension two variables. I'm going to dimension PI MDB context as a PI module, and that's going to give it the correct properties. And then I'm going to dimension a DB database limit variable as a double. And what I want to do is I want to determine the PI module database context, get the property that we had for that particular one, that particular module called design. And what I want to do is use the design variable, or the database limit, in my calculation. So the way we get that variable is that we have to set the PI module database context equal to that get PI module from path function that we talked about earlier. And so I will use the get PI module from path function, and remember that we can get the master ace context from the runtime variable. The master ace context is the current context. So instead of calling out a specific context, I simply tell ace get the current context. I then set my DB limit, my database limit variable, equal to the module database context dot PI properties. And I do need to define which property I need to get, and I will use the value function of that. So what I've done is I've dimensioned my two variables. I've set my context using the PI get PI module from path function, and then I've declared my database limit as the module context, design properties, current value. The only thing that's left to do is set the proper variable in my calculation and test my calculation. Once I test it, I can see if a value comes through. I see I've got a current value for flow. Select calculate now, and it does say CDT 158 is under range. So I know that at least I've typed everything correct, and the calculation still is syntactically correct. Let's see what we can do about going and testing that. Oh, don't forget to register your calculation before you leave the ACE application. Now, the real test to see if this works or not is by taking some of the variables and altering them to be something that will clearly violate the test that we made in the code. And if you remember, we said that if the value was greater than the database limit, we were going to be normal. But if it was not greater than the limit, we were going to say that the tag was under range. And so what I've done is I've changed the design specifications on unit 1 and unit 3 to be 200, which would, the current values for these tags are clearly under that. And what you're going to see as we watch the values go through, watch the output log tag go through its cycle, is that when we have 258 and 458 appear, those will be normal. However, when CDT-158 and CDT-358 appear, their tests will come under range. So, and you can see that clearly it's demonstrated that. So not only have we taken one equation and propagated it across multiple units, but we've also used that module path that we're getting, and we have derived a property from it and use that within the calculation as well. So you can see that you can make your calculations as specific or as generic as possible, and if they're generic as possible, if they're generic or more on the generic side, you can simply make tweaks to the module database to alter the calculation using a variable, a property as a variable. And you can make tweaks to the calculation without having to go in and create a new calculation or recompile or do anything like that in the development environment. So ACE, using the module database, is a very, very powerful tool.